I'm Lydia. You can find me as Lydia B on Ravelry and Lydia Knits on Instagram.
It's episode 25.
It is episode. She's laughing because we just had to look that up because we couldn't remember and then I totally forgot to tell you. And it's Monday, November 24th, and it's 9 o'clock at night.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'm Sarah Stevens, also known as Sarah Stevens. Sarah Stevens and Sarah Stevens 11.
So yes.
Yes. I almost think we should start over. No. We'll leave it.
We're just gonna go. Somebody told us we were really good at this, so we're just gonna right. Roll with that. You guys think we're good at this.
Right. We're gonna roll with it.
Yep.
She's gonna keep on going.
It's Monday.
And we've had a long day. We have been shipping stuff. So all of mustache kits
are out.
And mustache anything went out today.
Mm-hmm.
Out the door.
We're getting all kinds of things ready.
All sorts of things, and we're going to talk about that later.
Mm-hmm.
That's been happening.
Yes.
But, yeah.
Yeah. Well, okay, jump right in. I have no finished things, none whatsoever.
I have a ton of finished things. You don't get to see any of them. So.
She's really mean to you guys. She doesn't let you see anything. I get to see all of it, though.
Nothing. Although, I can tell you it's all really fun and exciting, and I'm super stoked by all of it. And you're going to get to see it in the next couple weeks.
Mm-hmm.
It'll go up soon.
Yes.
Soonly.
Yeah.
Soon-ish.
Soon-ish.
So, yeah. Yeah, I really don't have anything to show you. I can show you what I'm looking at now.
Yeah. What is that?
New socks. They're out of this yarn, though, so I'm not going to show you really the sock, but I'm going to show you the yarn. And it is a new-to-me yarn. It is Cascade Longwood. I don't know if you can see the tag. There's kind of glare. It's 100% superwash extra fine merino. It's a worsted weight. And you get 191 yards. And it feels like there's cashmere.
It's like dreamy, guys. I need to sleep on it, I think.
Right?
Yeah.
I need to roll in it.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not a huge Cascade 220 fan. Like, the superwash, I feel like it's a little scratchy. This is like heaven.
Mm-hmm.
I love it a whole lot. And there, we, at a Grand Yarn, got a ton of colors. But there might be more than what we got. But there's a huge array.
Yeah.
Anyways, there's like a golden color and this cranberry. And there's like a wine and plum and magenta and beautiful blues and browns and khaki green, you name it. So I got 3 skeins, and these were them.
Oh, I have to just point out that these are the same colors that are in the sweater that you started knitting after Vogue. They're all the same colors.
Okay. So, come... I might have a thing for these colors.
You might.
If it just had a mustard.
Mm-hmm.
Then I would have...
It would be all the same things.
It would be the exact same thing. Oh, and look at this. It kind of just matches your scarf. That's really funny, too.
It does.
If you have not tried Cascade Longwood, you really need to. I'm not even joking.
It's super squishy.
This isn't my enabling part, but it kind of is because it's my whip. So, I just roll in it. It's amazing.
Mm-hmm.
Totally amazing.
Well, I have been working on one thing and one thing only every moment of the day since we saw each other last time. I take that back. Not when I'm dyeing yarn, but yeah. I am working on the dress from HE Double Hockey Sticks.
Okay. But you have to admire, like, okay. How old's Jillian?
She's 6, but she's a big 6.
She's tall.
She's very tall.
She's like the same size as Vanessa.
Yeah.
And she's 12.
Yeah.
So
I have all of the top and the top and the back, and so
I've done already
a lot of the body. I have, believe it or not, guys, I still have about 4 inches of the variegated to go, and then I can do a hem. So, yeah, I still have some knitting to do.
So, hello, tunic? Is that what you're saying?
No. I keep thinking, like, I'll just stop and make it a tunic, but I set out to make her a dress, and I really want to make her a dress, so I don't know. I'm going to get through. I have this much left of this skein. So I'm going to get through this and then measure and see where we're at, and maybe not want the other one and do the other one. So
I wouldn't.
We're just going to have to see where we are when we
get
there.
It's like endless stockinette.
It totally is. And there's a lot of stitches
on this
thing.
It's beautiful.
Yeah. I really like it. I think she's going to like it too. And my thought is, if I just block it out really, really good,
just pull it.
Right?
Yeah. And it's candy skein, right?
Yeah.
So.
Yeah. Our yarn on the top, it's the Hermione Granger colorway, and our platinum, and then the candy skein at the bottom. And this is it's from her Yummy series, and it's her confetti cupcake colorway. Sorry,
I didn't
guys,
even know there was a series. It's a Yummy series?
Yeah, this one's called her Yummy series. I'll see if I have the, I do, but I have the tag. Yeah, candyskein.com. Yes, and she calls this her Yummy series. It's fingering weight. 465 grams, 75% superwash merino, 25% nylon, which is basically the same exact thing as what our platinum is.
You have to show them this, though. She puts...
Oh, yeah, a little...
this little bead.
I don't know if you guys will be able to see.
With every skein. Every skein.
Has... Is it the same one, or is it, are there different ones? Yeah.
Different.
So, she puts
I think it's just random. Like, I don't necessarily know that she coordinates them.
So, that's her.
But she does it on her sport
that's
weight
her.
And everything.
Yeah.
So, I don't know... all of her bases. Ah!
Dog's trying to eat popcorn.
I can't see my popcorn.
Yeah. So, I'm really enjoying the way it's knitting up. I did kind of have to laugh. So, I got through all of the increases for the body and realized that the yarn was starting to make these little, like, circles of color. And I was like, oh, I don't like that. That's going to bug me.
Yeah.
So, then I went back and, like, just decreased one section. And it didn't do that. So it's like, it was just that one set of increases that made it do it. So I went back down, but...
Interesting.
I don't think it'll notice it.
I don't remember who I was talking with, but we were talking about, pooling. No! Somebody was talking... I wasn't talking to anybody. I'm losing it. Molly. A homespun house.
Mm-hmm.
Her sweater.
Yeah. On her sleeves.
Somebody had talked to her about... you know, possibly just decreasing or changing the stitch count somehow. And it's so funny because we know this as dyers and as knitters that
really does do it.
Really does do it. But you don't think about that.
No. And I didn't.
In the midst of it.
I didn't even. Because until you start knitting it, you don't know how it's going to do it. But all I had to do was look at the previous rows and go, okay, well, it didn't do it there before I increased. So if I just decreased those stitches that I had increased, it'll go back and not do it anymore. So there's a few rows where there's little pops, but the colorway is so random because of how it's dyed that it won't matter. So yeah, I'm going to get through this skein and see where we are and just see if I can fudge it by blocking it out and go from there. Because the measurement for her underarm is supposed to be 19 inches, I believe. And then there's like a 3-inch hem, which puts it under her knees, which is originally what I wanted because I wanted her to be able to wear it for a while.
Okay.
But if you look at the picture of the dress is above the knee. And as long as she was wearing leggings under it, or shorts even, it'd probably be okay if it didn't come under her knee. So I'm going to measure it, like I said, when I get to the end of the skein and see where we are.
And stretch it.
And stretch it out. And just probably make it work, because I really want to knit other things, you guys. And I want to be able to enter it for points, because it's supposed to be my number challenge. So
I need to... steal my scarf
from my dad. You need to take your scarf back so you can take pictures of it.
So I can have an under
challenge. Yeah.
I showed it though. Can that count?
No. You still gotta put it in
the thing. Freeze the picture.
Probably. I could probably do that.
In case I can't get it back.
I'll figure it out.
These are the conversations that happen when you all are not around.
Yes.
Normally.
Yes.
What else are you working on?
Nothing. She's just doing that to be mean, you guys. Nothing. I haven't knit a single thing on anything else for 2 weeks. I texted her and my cousin the other day, and I'm like, I can't do it anymore. Like, I have been knitting so long today, my arm is numb. Like, I can't do it anymore.
Your arm.
Remember? And I texted
yes,
you?
That's right.
Because I'm like, I can't do it anymore. My arm is like burning. It hurts.
And it was cold in your house.
Yeah. It was cold in my house. My fingers were about to fall off.
Speaking of temperature in houses, we bought a quart of wood this year. We've never bought a quart of wood. In fact, I didn't really know what a quart of wood looked like. We've had fireplaces growing up. And we've chopped wood, but I think we've only ever maybe gotten a quarter of a quart of wood. So they dump it in my driveway last weekend. Dump it. And the boys were so nice that helped us restack it. Like, there were two guys, and maybe they were their late 20s, early 30s, helped me restack it in our garage and with my kids. And my dad. But we've been having our fireplace going. You obviously can't see it right now. Some of you who follow me on Instagram know what it looks like. It's right over here. I have no heat on in my house at all. The furnace is turned off, and it was, what was the last temperature?
78? Yeah. And I'm basically just a puddle over here because I'm married to the heat Nazi.
No, you're not.
And it's like an igloo at my house. So it is freezing.
It is so hot.
So you walk in here and I'm way overdressed. As you can see, she's wearing short
sleeves. Tank top.
I'm wearing long sleeves and I'm like.
But when we switch places, I'm like bundled with my hat and sweater and coat. I'm like. It's so funny. Mm-hmm. So, yes. Yeah, I had to point that out because if we have if we start sweating.
Yeah.
It could
we're
be
glistening a little bit
right next to the fireplace.
Mm-hmm.
That's happening.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But it's nice.
It's so nice. Like, it's so nice that I want to open the window. But then I feel guilty. You know what I mean? Like, it's like the totally. Summertime and you're like,
it's hot in here.
It's so hot in here. And you're like, but I should appreciate the heat, so I shouldn't touch any type of device. No fans.
Yeah.
Don't open the window. Even though you have no heat running, it's, I don't know, it's messed up. And we have a guest.
Oh.
Did you see him?
Oh, yeah. I'm like, we do.
What are you talking about? He made it back.
I thought she was seeing things. You could see
him. He did.
He was
visiting.
He was gone for
a
while.
He was on vacation for a while.
He's back.
Yeah, so he's back.
Mr. Humphrey.
He's so sweet.
I need to knit him a sweater, though. He needs a sweater.
Oh, my gosh. Oh, my gosh. Everybody should knit him a sweater, and then we should change his sweater on a podcast.
Oh, we should. You guys should totally do that. Okay, so we're starting it. We're starting the Humphrey sweater. I'll knit the first one so I can tell you how big you need to make it.
Perfect.
Okay, I'm doing it.
I'll knit.
After I finish the dress stuff. From you know where. I finished this.
I'm saying tunic.
Just... She's been tooting the tunic horn for about 3 days now. Because she would have been over it a long time ago.
It would have been a tank top sooner or later. It would have been like...
And like a half shirt.
Those belly shirts? You just wear one of those longer shirts underneath the middle. Fine, it's in style, right?
No.
No?
No. No, it's not. That's funny.
It's like the...
But see, this is why you get through things. Because your children are tiny. So, like, their regular size is like that of a midget. So, they are teeny tiny little people.
Right.
My children are not big, but they're not teeny tiny.
This speaks to my patience level.
Yes, it does. This is why you have small children, apparently. God knew you wouldn't get through large size projects. I have no idea what's happening with this podcast right now. I'm just going to be honest. It's too late.
It is 9:30 at night.
It's too late.
It's, 9:30
anyway.
And we wound shop stuff.
Mm-hmm. Yes, we did.
We had to enlist wine. So,
yeah.
That might be a little bit.
Could be. Just a little bit. Okay, well that covers my whips and my non-existent foes.
And I can't show you anything else.
So
that's it.
So that's the knitting.
That's all of our knitting.
Moving on.
So we've been thinking, the last podcast, or the one before that, we had mentioned how much we wanted to do a 12 in 12 month kind of a deal. And then last night, to be truthfully honest, I was like, that would be really fun. Is if we did a 12 and 12 month thing, but we also had like a fun little book club thing. So, a long time ago, we used to read books together, and we have a Rocca.
We used to read books together.
Yeah.
We did.
It was so much fun. And our book club was really awesome, and we still get together. But it's more like a movie club or
restaurant.
Chatting. Restaurant club. Like, let's go check out the restaurant.
Mm-hmm.
There's like no reading.
No.
At all. Anymore. And, we had been talking about how much we missed it. Mm-hmm. Like, it was, I don't know, it was really fun. So, maybe we take it virtually. So, we aren't just meeting in your house or my house, essentially. But each week, we kind of touch base and say, you know, hey, we're reading chapters, whatever, through whatever, or whatever. And then at the end of the month, we talk about a book. And twice a year, we do the Rocca, which is the read-along and knit-along. So you get a bag and a kit and the whole nine yards. But for the rest of the time, we're just going to read along with you guys. And we're going to pick a book and say, hey, Ohloops is reading this month. And we can talk about it and have fun. And then we'll do a fun podcast drawing. So it'll be mostly a podcast thing. Sometimes we'll draw bookmarks or stitch markers or whatever, and it won't start until January. I'm not doing anything in December right now.
Yeah.
We got a lot of stuff going on.
So, think about that and kind of tell us what you guys think. If that's something you'd be interested in doing. Because we had a lot of fun with our book club, and we do miss it.
A lot.
So,
like, I think it would be a ton of fun, and I particularly have, like, 4 books in mind, but if nobody wants to do it, then, you know, obviously I'll just read alone. All by myself.
Loner.
I'm kind of hoping you're all going to be like, yes.
Yes.
We'll join you.
Yes.
So, let us know.
And then also, be thinking about this, because we've kind of been throwing around some ideas for how we want our 12 and 2015 thing to work.
Yeah.
So, we originally thought that we would run it similar, and I think we still kind of are thinking about running it similar to how the other group was,
like
in the sense that we'll knit 12 items, and Sarah and I haven't decided what we think that item should be yet, but each month you'll have the option of voting on 5 beginner, like, so let's just use shawls for, you know,
right,
whatever. So you'd have 5 beginner, like, easy, anyone can knit them shawls to vote on.
Yep.
And then you'd have more advanced shawls that, you know, maybe have more lace or they're charted or whatever to vote on. And you would get to vote on those, and the one that had the most votes, of course, would be the one that everyone would knit. And if you want to do the beginner one, you can, or if you want to do the advanced one, you can. You don't have to do both. You can if you choose to, but you don't have to. Mm-hmm. So there would be that option, and you would do that with whatever yarn, and we'd all knit the same pattern. In addition to that, we were kind of thinking it would be fun. Sarah and I have fallen in love with the kits that we've been making in the shop.
Totally,
so we thought it would be fun that, so you'd have that option, but then you could have the knit.
Ohloops option.
You'd have the Ohloops option, so you could knit that pattern with a kit that we dye specifically for that month.
Yes.
And
minimal kits. Like, there's not going to be a bunch of them.
Yeah. And we thought it would be kind of fun to, like, to encourage you or to get you excited about using the Ohloops option. That if you bought all 11, you'd maybe get the 12th one
free.
So,
mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And we'd still do fun little drawings,
mm-hmm.
kind of a thing for that too. So,
yes. So yeah, so
we gotta think about that.
Think about what you guys think about that and if that's something you would be interested in, because we would probably need to start voting on the January pattern.
And
in
January's
December.
Patterns are going to, we already know, January will be socks.
Yeah.
So.
Oh, yes. I guess we should explain that too. So the
we
kit,
already know
if
that
you
January's
decide to do the
socks.
Ohloops, so if you decide to do the Ohloops option, you wouldn't be knitting the pattern that you voted on with the yarn.
No.
You would be knitting a pattern that comes in the kit.
In the Ohloops kit.
Yeah. So there'd be the, I'm knitting these 12 shawls, or I'm knitting these 12 Ohloops patterns.
Right, and that works both ways. So
yes.
You can either buy the whole kit, which comes with the yarn and the pattern and some fun goodies, and a project bag and everything in the shop in January, or you can just purchase the pattern from whomever's designer page,
because
mm-hmm. she's doing it now too. And so it would be from either or, and you can use stash yarn. But mm-hmm. either way, there's going to be an Ohloops option, and then there would be the beginner and then the advanced option. And so
yeah.
for now, January is socks.
Designed by her. So, be kind of thinking about that so you guys can give us your opinions on whether or not that's something you would be interested in
mm-hmm.
as well. So.
Because
we do have a lot of patterns and kit ideas kind of planned out, and we're dreaming them up, but if it's not something you guys are interested in, then it's not as much fun to continue
right.
doing that. So let us know. While we're on shop stuff, we might as well just continue with shop stuff. We are going to be doing a fun sale. So we're going to be starting on Friday. So for Black Friday, we will have a coupon code available, and then we will also be doing it for Small Business Saturday, and that will carry through till Sunday, and then again on Cyber Monday. So on Friday, for Black Friday, we will be releasing our new Christmas color, which I love. I just got done dyeing all of them today,
mm-hmm.
and I really love them. So
I'm in love.
They will be available on our sport weight. And then they will also be available on our new single ply bulky. And then I will have all of the colorways that are in that skein dyed as semi-solids on worsted.
Yeah.
In addition with some other colors as well. But those will be going up in the shop on Friday.
I'm in love with that.
So for Friday, you will have a 10% off coupon that will only be good for Friday. And that coupon code is All I Want for Christmas. All one word.
Isn't it Mariah Carey who said
mm-hmm.
that song?
Yes. On Saturday, there won't be new yarn in the shop on Saturday. You're just getting an additional coupon code.
Yeah.
a different coupon code. To celebrate Small Business Saturday.
Mm-hmm.
And Sarah and I decided to have that one be a 15% off coupon code. It will be good for Saturday and Sunday.
Yeah.
And that coupon code is Ohloops. No apostrophe, just O-H-L-O-O-P-S. Ohloops. I spelled that one right, guys. And then Cyber Monday, there will be new yarn in the shop on Monday. Those are our skeins that we're calling our snowbird skeins because they're more tropical, summer, beachy inspired.
Yes.
In honor of all of the
go away from all the snow.
Go away from the snow. So, and
if you have any, East Coast I think has some.
Yeah.
Not us.
We did have some. It all melted though.
It all melted.
But so for Cyber Monday, you will have a new coupon code that you can use. It'll be, so this is the way this one's going to work. So we do have some Escalera kits in the shop still.
Mm-hmm.
If they are still there on Monday, this coupon code will not really directly affect those. But you can buy two skeins of yarn and get a third skein of yarn at 50% off, which is a fixed price, so it will just give you $12 off since our yarn is all listed at $22. So it's a little more than 50%, but
so
it'll only take $12 off no matter what you buy, but you do have to buy at least the two skeins.
So let's say you buy a skein of yarn and an Escalera kit and another skein of yarn, then you would still only get $12 off.
Right.
Or if you bought three skeins of yarn,
you'd get one.
You get at just
off.
$12
yes.
off.
And that particular coupon will only be good for Monday. And that coupon code is must have it, all one word. So, and I thought it was kind of cute that our coupon codes say, all I want for Christmas, Ohloops, must have it.
I'm in love with my yarn. This one's mine.
Yep, she's wearing it.
Y'all aren't getting this one.
I'm in love with it on the single ply.
Oh, God.
Oh, we didn't tell anybody the name. Should we tell anybody the name?
Oh!
Ready?
Uh-huh.
Okay. Not my gumdrop buttons!
Oh. So, I was talking to my husband. And we were talking about, like...
We couldn't come up with a name. We were trying, like, what do we name it?
Yeah, I was like, what are we going to name this? And he's like, made this stupid Shrek reference. Stop.
Yeah. Not my gumdrop buttons.
So. I don't know. There's a glare. Can you see the green? The green and the cherry and the really awesome blue... In the natural. Oh, not my gumdrop buttons.
I'm happy with the way it came out. I like it.
I'm getting the splinter. I want the bulky. More.
Now seeing it in person.
Yeah.
Yes. So, those will be up on Friday. The snowbird skeins will go up on Monday. In addition to that, on December 8th, we are releasing all of our Christmas kits. So, they will go up on December 8th. And then we will not have another update until January.
I really like this. It just might be my help at night. the kits.
Mm-hmm.
Will not be this colorway.
Mm.
And they will not be the snowbird colorway. But they will be this colorway with brown or this colorway with glitter.
Yes.
So
there's one other one too though. It's not
right,
that colorway at
it's
all.
Not that so. At all. So but just know that, like, if you want this on these two bases, they won't be available
in the
later.
Game. Yeah, they're only going to be up on Friday. So once they're gone, they're gone.
Yep, that's it.
Yeah.
So.
Yes, yes. I think that's all for, like, shop...
Updates.
I do have... I guess I'll include this in the... No, I guess we'll do now. The wonderful Daniela... Caffeinated Gert of the wonderful knitting Caffeinated Knitting Podcast with Miss Allie, Crafty Allie, is designing a beautiful shawl that
so
she's
awesome.
Calling the Invisibility Cloak,
mm-hmm.
and she's knitting it currently with our Chamber of Secrets colorway.
Mm-hmm.
She's wonderful, you guys. She is having it test knit right now, and she is going to be giving a copy of it to all of the Harry Potter winners. I'm so excited. It's cool. So, that will be happening. So, thank you, Danielle.
I think I need to knit that in my Potter colorway.
Ooh, yes.
Don't I?
Yes, you do.
Mm-hmm.
You should.
I should.
She should. I don't know what I'm going to make it out of. I'm not sure. And last but not least on my little list of notes, wanted to let you know that Jackie's coupon code, the Ohloops podcast, is still good until January 1st. Mm-hmm. Use that, 25% off. She's got some awesome stuff. She's also wonderful and is going to be giving bags and lotion bars to me when I go over there in a couple weeks to give you guys in the 2015 365-day stash down giveaway.
So, I'm so excited.
So some of you will be getting bags and lotion bars from Lip Syncing Ladybug at lipsyncingladybug.etsy.com.
Mm-hmm.
I think that's it.
On my notes. Love those hand lotion bars.
Yes, me too.
Mine are over there.
Mine's not with me because it was on my table where I knit, and I was using it earlier today after I dyed all the yarn because my hands were dry.
Mm. Mine is the orange cream.
Okay. Since we were just talking about her, I told you last time I might have more bags coming.
Give it.
I do.
Oh! Shut up! This is so cute.
I'm ready.
Yes. So, Lip Syncing Ladybug. It's my Christmas bag.
For you?
For me. It's not for you. I love you, but. Oh my gosh, it matches our colorway!
It does!
It matches our colorway!
Do you guys see this?
Oh,
I need this.
Oh.
Jackie?
I think there's one in the shop right now. It's a four-paneled one. It doesn't look exactly like that.
I like these colors.
Because I throw a tantrum on the line. Matches my colorway. She's trying to steal it. Do you guys see this right now? She's totally like, I'm back. But I love it.
It's so
it's
cute.
My Christmas bag.
It's so cute.
We may have other Christmas bags coming from somebody else pretty soon too.
Oh no, we don't even have to keep that a secret. So, Molly from Homespun
Straight.
We have none. She posted this picture on Instagram and she's like, oh, I'm making all my Christmas bags. And
we fell in love with all of them.
All of them. And so we bought two of them. We settled on two.
We did.
We did good.
We did. I also bought one of her little cozy pocket warmer things.
I need you to get that here so I can see it.
I'm excited.
I love them. The little kid one.
Mm-hmm.
You bought the kid.
I did. I bought the little kid one because I love
hand warmers.
Yes,
warmers.
I fell in love with the fabric on one of the kid ones. It was
so cute.
Little bumblebees or something.
Mm-hmm.
Bees, right?
Yeah, they were little bees.
And it was like the background is green and the little bees I think are pink, maybe. Yeah, it's
so cute.
So I'm excited about that. That should be here soonly.
I need.
Didn't you have yarn anything you were gonna show?
I showed it.
Oh, was that just it? That? Okay.
It was just the cascade. We are all over the place.
I know. Sorry, guys.
We
kind of are just all over, but it's okay. You love us anyway, right?
You should hear, like, our conversations on a regular basis.
You're scary.
This is, like,
you guys probably
really good.
I think you might have us sent away. There. This is, like, therapy for us. It's good. I have more enabling because I'm a total dork and... My favorite book ever is Wuthering Heights. And every year around Thanksgiving, over the Thanksgiving Christmas holiday, I read it. And I was telling Sarah that every year I buy a new book, and it's not, I don't think it's every year. Probably every couple of years I buy myself a new copy.
You bought yourself a new copy last year.
I did. And I bought myself a new copy this year, too. So this is my newest copy. That's right, because I got the little purple one, which is actually my favorite copy. And this is my new copy this year. And I do. I read it every year. So if you haven't read this book, you should read it. It's by Emily Bronte. It's called Wuthering Heights.
If you wanted to do an informal read along with Ohloops, we should just do that for December. That would be kind of fun.
Ooh, we should.
It's not
and I even have a copy
yet.
Sarah can borrow.
Actually, I have like six.
Oh, I have more than that. But I honestly, no joke, you guys, I think if I were to go through all of my boxes in the garage... I probably have, like, 15 copies of it.
Like, what?
Probably. because each one is... The story never changes, but each book is a little different, and I love that. It's something new each time. So, yes, I agree. If you guys want to read this with me for December, I start it the day after Thanksgiving. You should read it. Wuthering Heights, Emily Bronte. You can find it at any Barnes & Noble. A lot of times it's in the classics, so they're cheap. You can find it at cheapbooks.com. You can find it on Amazon.
Cheapbooks.com is really cool if you guys have never utilized that.
It's awesome.
It's better than Amazon, in my opinion.
Mm-hmm.
Way cheaper. Totally my opinion. way cheaper. I love it.
Yep.
We've used it multiple times.
So, I will start a thread for this. If anybody wants to read it.
That would be really
amongst
fun.
All the other Harry Potter threads that are coming on.
I think it fills up like the whole board.
It does. It really does.
My poor Slytherins. They probably think I'm non-existent.
Your Slytherins were awarded 150 points today because
Lily's
package was received by her swap partner.
Oh, you swap people? You rock my socks off. Because, Julie, I haven't even started yours yet. Like, I figuratively started yours in my brain. Not, there's not anything to show for it.
I've picked up some stuff.
But my deep, dark thoughts. I have nothing.
I have some stuff. I'm not done with my knitted thing, though.
The weekend after Thanksgiving. Oh, I'm designating.
It's a whole Julie swap package weekend?
You're gonna have to hold me to it. Yes!
Okay, I'll hold her to it. I'm good.
Yes. Because I need to get it done. I need to do it. It's not because I don't want to. It's just because 9 million things are going through my little brain.
Mm-hmm.
Rod.
Yeah, there we are.
I'm going to pawn it off on Humphrey.
I'm going to try to have Humphrey's sweater done by the time we podcast next. I'm going to try. We'll see what happens.
It's the Monday after Thanksgiving.
We'll see what happens. It might happen. It might be on the needles. There we go. It'll be on the needles.
That is probably the more appropriate thing
to
say. Probably. Then you can just cast on.
Our children. Are you guys almost done?
Are you almost done?
I shouldn't say our children. Her children. I only have one of my children. Too. We did want to do this because we haven't done six in a long time.
We haven't done this in forever.
Sorry.
I have to get the popcorn.
Terrible questions.
This is kind of fun. This is fun. It doesn't change for us, but it will for some people. Now in your 30s, what, if anything, do you view drastically different than when in your 20s?
Yeah.
Okay. This is why this doesn't change. I had kids in my 20s.
Me too.
So it's not that.
Honestly, I have to say it has come down to the last couple of months. And I think it's...
What is important?
Yeah, what's really important. And like, we were at one of our small groups, and it was all about stressors. And the small group leader, the family pastor at our church, he's like, okay, so everyone put their hands behind their back, and like, one is not real stressed, five is like stressed beyond the max. And he's like, and I want everyone to put their hand behind their back and hold up how many fingers, and then we'll all raise our hand, you know, to show you fingers. I was the only person in the room who had a five. And he's like, really? Wow. Why is it a five? And so I was going through this list of, like, you know, this and that and this. And it's like, I sat there and I was like, I put so much pressure on myself to be perfect, to be, you know, to be a perfectionist and to have a spotless house and to have everything done on time and to make sure that, you know, everything is done a certain way. And I spend so much time stressing about that I don't really take care of myself emotionally or physically. And my kids, a lot of times, I feel like they suffer too because it's like, well, mommy has to do this, so I can't do that with you. And it's like, lately, I'm just like, no, you know what? I didn't mop the floor today. I didn't vacuum today. There's dishes in the sink. Like, yeah, whatever. And it's not that I've just all of a sudden just become a slob. Like, I'm still,
no.
I'm not, but it's like, my kids are more important. Like,
it's because
Tuesdays,
the dishes will be there tomorrow.
Totally.
Your kids won't be whatever.
Little tomorrow.
Yeah, and they are tomorrow. They're
gonna be here. And I've just decided that it's all about my family and spending time with my husband and my kids. And aside from doing like a few minor things, like Tuesday has become my kid day. Like I spend all day with Noah because it's the only day I don't have the other little guys during the week anyway. And then like when the girls get home from school, we try to do something fun. And then my husband and I have just kind of decided that Tuesday's really, until soccer starts again, the only night we don't have something going on. So it's going to be family game night. And, you know, we're just going to make it a priority to do those things. And I think in my 20s, I was so, like, I don't know. I was just, I think, honestly, when you're 20, and I was 20 when my oldest was born, I think you get so stuck on, well, I'm so young, and I want people to think I'm a good parent, so I have to be perfect.
You hit the nail on the head, because that is it's changed for me.
Yeah, like, and I understand, it's like, my kids can throw fits, and, like, today, I went to the store, and my son had breakfast all over his shirt, and I didn't even realize it until we got there, and I was like, normally, I wouldn't have gone in the store, like, with Emma, there is no way I would have allowed myself to go out in public with her being dirty. And I have finally just let that go. It's like, I am not the only mom of small children who has to run errands and who has to do things with a kid who has dirty stuff on their shirt. Like, it's okay. I'm not the only parent whose kids throw fits because they don't get what they want. So, to me, I don't stress out about little things anymore. I mean, I do, but I'm trying not to as much.
I think you're trying to way more. Yeah. Like, even just since I've known you.
Yeah.
I've seen you not totally crazy about how your kid's appearance is, but, be way more relaxed.
Yeah.
Not in a bad way. I must say that, but, like, just, like, my kids will show up in sweatpants and a tank top and one red sock and one blue sock.
Totally.
You know, and I'm just happy we got out the door.
Exactly.
You know what I mean?
And I'm getting to that point, too. It's like, hey, we made it out, and
woo!
Yeah. One, it's funny, because I think
we're done.
I think events, it happened in your life for you to kind of realize those things. Like, I started realizing this thing about the clothes thing when Jillian was little, because for 6 months, probably.
She wore rain boots.
She wore rain boots every single day, no matter what she had on. Not only that,
dress.
None of that. She couldn't leave the house unless she was wearing a dress-up dress. So we...
I didn't get it!
We were in dress-up dresses and rain boots pretty much every single day. And I was just like, meh, not fighting this child on it anymore. I'm just not going to do it. I'm not going to squash her little personality. Just
but all of us were baffled. We're like, you cannot... It's snowing. Huh? Rain boots and a dress. And she was adamant. Like, it didn't matter who talked to her.
Nope. Or it could be 90 degrees out, and she was still wearing rain boots and tights and a dress-up dress. Yep. Honey, you're gonna melt.
Yeah. And she had heat stroke in my backyard.
She did. She did.
Because of it.
Because
so stubborn.
So I think that's, honestly, for me, yeah, it's the what's really important. And letting things go, not having to be a perfectionist, not... And being okay with that. Being okay with not being a perfectionist.
I've never been a perfectionist, ever. I am as far night as she is day.
Mm-hmm.
I am not organized in any normal manner. I'm organized for me.
You have your own system of organization.
But it is not like anybody else. And Lydia is extremely organized.
That's a good word for it.
My husband's tiptoeing through the kitchen right now. And I can see it on the other side. So I would say that this business partnership has been a growth experiment. Because the very first time that we sat down to do this podcast, a year ago, Lydia typed up a book. Go to the fire. I can't do it from here. I tried.
I did.
And I called her back the next day and I said, I am not reading from this book. What do you want me to do? And I was like, well, can't I just have sticky notes, like, on a paper, and we'll just, like, look at them? And he was like, no, we'll forget something. I was like, but no, we'll have a general idea. That is how our business works.
Yeah.
If you ever asked her 5 years ago if that is who she would be working with, she would have said, hell no.
I don't think so. I think it's been good for both of us, though.
It's been so good because I've learned some organizational skills. My creativity cannot just completely overtake me.
Mm-hmm. I put the brakes on every once in a while.
She does.
The reins back.
She's like, nah, that. Hurt.
I don't know if that's going to work.
Right. Yeah. A lot, actually. A lot of the time. Because I'll call her at, like, 11 o'clock at night. Like, we should do this. She's like, that's on Monday.
Yeah.
How are you going to do that?
It's now Sunday.
It's not going to happen. Aw. Okay, next year.
Mm-hmm.
Next time. So that's been good. But in my 30s, as far as my 20s go, it's so similar. I've never been worried about what people really care about me or think about me. And that's going to come across terrible. It's going to come across completely terrible, and it's not meant terrible. It's just, I don't tend to look for outward acceptance as much as I do for internal acceptance. Like, am I feeling like I am making the difference that I need to be making, or am I doing my best, or am I doing whatever? It's always been focused more on me with inwardly, and even though I took this test and it was like I'm more outward, mm-hmm. you know, I guess I should be more focused on what other people think. I don't know. So for me, in my 30s, as opposed to my 20s, I have let go of what I feel is necessary more and have embraced what other people feel is appropriate more. That sounds funny. That sounds really funny, but I take other people's opinions, wants, dreams, wishes, into what I want to do and make it a possibility. Mm-hmm. Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm.
I don't even know if that makes sense.
It does.
Like, I used to be more self-centered in a terrible way, like, not in a bad way, just...
I don't know that I would say self-centered. What I'm seeing is you're becoming a more...
Rounded.
You're more of an emotive person now. Like,
right.
You... Before, you were kind of, you tended to be somewhat closed off and didn't let a lot of people in.
No, I still don't do that, but I do it better.
But more now.
I do it better.
Yeah, more so now than before.
My don't touch me bubble has gotten bigger.
Yes. That has happened.
I'll hug you if I like you. No, it's not mine. I'll let you off. Everyone's in.
Yes.
It's good. So, that's happened in my 30s as opposed to my 20s.
Yeah.
My husband's starting a fire pit right now. Can you hear him?
Probably.
It sounds like somebody's running into my house. I also learned in my 30s, I am a terrible firewood chopper. I can make firewood like this size. I cannot make kindling. I've almost chopped off my toe, like, twice.
So maybe you should not chop wood with flip-flops on.
That is besides the point. If I had boots on, it would be the same scenario.
There's that. But you probably didn't. Did you? You had flip-flops on, huh? She's smiling because she knows I'm right.
I'm drinking my water.
She pleads the fifth. Okay, as much as I don't want to say goodbye, we kind of have to, guys, because my husband wanted this to end, like, 20 minutes ago.
What is it?
We're at 57 minutes. Because he wants to get it edited tonight so that he can put it up for you guys tomorrow, which I would like as well. So.
Okay, I think that'll be it.
So, Black Friday, stuff will be in the shop. Mm-hmm. Happy Thanksgiving, everyone. We hope you guys have a great holiday.
We will read the book.
Yes, read the book. We will chat with you next time. Bye.